Howdy all, Mockwood Fireman here, and welcome back to the Farlanders Patreon server. And as you can see, the sun is rising. There's no glitching. Connection is good. No problems. No problem whatsoever so far today. Last episode, we were having some problems with connection and lag and everything else. Kurt got a hold of the people that were running the server, got everything reset. Apparently, there was some kind of... if you check out the comments in that episode, Cacille explained it. I'm not a technical guy. I don't know. I just know that it's fixed now. And I do appreciate Cacille. And I've been on for about an hour screwing around up there. And I just now noticed that. Hey there! Said I would visit you, Ollie Parsley. So very forth, this is my humble offering. So Ollie Parsley is a member of the Farlanders Patreon server here, and he commented on one of my videos earlier. He's one of the new subscribers. So hello, Ollie, and thank you for subscribing. There's also a link to his channel in the description. He's got some pretty good stuff going on. Hopefully he'll have some videos here on the Patreon server that we could check out here pretty soon. So let's see what Mr. Ollie Parsley left us. Oh, yes. Yes, Ollie, thank you. Oh, that's amazing. And that will go well because I think it was Ace Morologist let me know that in here that the white walls and the stained clay are the best. And I haven't actually done any of that. I'll get to that off camera. That's not something I'm going to do on camera. But thank you, Ollie. This will help out tremendously. Blue stained clay. Yes, Ollie. Thank you. Thank you, good sir. Make sure you go check out Ollie's channel. He's got some cool stuff going on. All right. So we're going to finish up. We're going to continue on. This is our first new home, family's first new home after we moved out of the childhood home over there. And I did a little bit. We had hardwood floors throughout the whole downstairs here. This is where the kitchen and the breakfast area are going to be. This is bathroom over here. And we'll talk about what all this stuff is. But I got some floors down, hardwood floors throughout. This is the garage in here. So you pull your cars in. And let's just go. I think I'm going to use spruce wood for the walls. I don't know how good it's going to look, but I have a lot of spruce wood, so that's what we're going to use. And if it doesn't look good, then I'll change it. But I think it's going to be all right. I think that it's going to be all right. And it's just going to be, right now, it's just going to be a large rectangle. It's just like all of my builds seem to end up starting out as. Hello? I don't want you there yet. Thank you. But this is going to have a little bit more shape to it than the childhood home because it's not just a rectangle. And I do need to change another thing on that over there, which when I make the change, I'll be sure to show you. But I forgot a little attachment. I can't remember if I mentioned it in a video before, but there's a little attachment on the back that I forgot to put in there that, again, my brother Ace Morologist was kind enough to point out to me. Both on the video itself and when we were playing the Division the other night. Speaking of which, if you're not, that's not where that goes. If you haven't seen it yet, me and my brother, Ace Morologist, are playing the Division. The brothers play the Division. That's going to be coming out. I'm doing this series on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and the Division is going to be Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. It's only going to be 3 episodes a week, just like this one, because, you know, I've talked about it before. I've only got 1 day to record. That's the wrong button. And, it gets, especially on games like that, that I do in 1080, you know, it takes forever for those to render. Like the first of episode of the Division was actually late on the first Tuesday that I was going to come out with it because it takes 4 hours, or on that one, because it was an hour long episode. It took 4 hours to render it. and it was almost finished. I was like at 3 hours and 45 minutes. I only had 15 minutes left, and then my computer crashed. So I had to start the whole thing over again. So it took me 8 hours to get the thing rendered, and then it took another hour and a half just to get it uploaded to YouTube. So that's why that episode of The Division was a little bit late. But yeah, check out that. Me and my brother, we have a good time playing video games together. We give each other a hard time, and it's a lot of fun. We have a lot of fun together. So make sure you check out, if you would, please, check out The Division. The brothers play The Division on Tuesdays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. But this house, that is a doorway. This house, like I said before, this is the first new home that our family moved into. I was only here for a couple of years not too long after we moved into this house is when I got hired on at the fire department. I hired on the fire department in the year 2000. So 16 years ago, I actually just had my 16-year anniversary with the county back in February. So 16 years I've been with the fire department, and it all started here. I would commute from here to the training center, which was about 30 minutes away. It was in the same county as the fire department that I work for, but it was on the opposite end of the county. Basically, we were on the far west end of the county, and the training center was more towards the middle of the county. So it was a long way away. It took me about 30 minutes to get there. But this is where it all started. This is where the fire department dream started for me. I think this is also where Minecraft hadn't been out for that long. So this isn't where I started playing Minecraft. There we go. This is, as I mentioned in the episode before, this is a much bigger house than than our childhood home. How much more we got left? We got a bit more. Much bigger house than our childhood home. It's not going to look like it because it's just, it wasn't a huge house. It wasn't like a mansion or anything, but it was a much bigger upgrade than that house over there. Oh, I'm going to need all these torches. Let me get these torches. Two stories with a full basement, and we'll get into the basement. I have a story about the basement and the house in general. I have many stories about the house, but one of them for sure is going to be interesting. That's going to come up in a couple of episodes, I'm sure, as I get to the basement. But in here, let's use some of Ollie's most generous gift right now, because I think that we're going to go again with the white stained clay on the inside, because just like that house over there and just like pretty much every other house I've ever seen, the interior walls are all sheetrock. And I'm going to be doing the same thing here. I'm going to leave the exterior walls like they are. I'm not going to double up the wall space just because it would make it too big. So you would come in if you use the garage, which we use the garage. A lot of people have their garage or storage and have to park their cars outside. And my mom, since she couldn't park inside over there, that was one of the things that she was adamant about. I'm going to have a garage. I'm going to park my car inside. I'm not going to use it as a storage room and have to park my car outside. So that's what she did. We always had room to park inside. She would park here. And since I was the oldest, because Ace Morologist, my older brother, had moved out into his own place by the time we moved in here. So I was the only other person driving. So I got this garage space until my sister, Razorbutt, started driving. And then she got the garage space and I had to park over here because she's the girl and she gets what she wants. I'm kidding, Razorbutt. Don't kill me. But yeah, like I said, I got this garage space. My mom got this garage space. There were a couple of times where there was one time in specific that I pulled in here and I was in a hurry to leave. And I actually tore my mirror off, backing out quickly because I wasn't paying attention because it was just barely wide enough for my truck. And I tore my mirror off on this right here, and I was very unhappy when I did that. And my mom was very unhappy because I damaged the garage door. I had to get it fixed. But, yeah. So inside, we're going to use the white stained clay, so generously provided by Mr. Ollie. And we're going to start here. Now, I'm leaving a space here because there was a storage room off of the garage right here. This was a storage room. This is where we stored our lawnmower because we didn't have outside storage when we first moved in. So we stored the lawnmower in here, and it was a little bit bigger. I mean, it wasn't just, you know, wide enough for one person to fit through. But for Minecraft, this is going to be good enough because there are no lawnmowers in regular Minecraft. So we would store I stored a lawnmower in here, all the gas and all that stuff for the lawnmower. The people who lived here before, this was actually like a workroom. So there was a little bit of storage, like a workbench and stuff like that. Now, one thing that I forgot to mention when I was building that house over there, the reason I say that I stored the lawnmower in here is because I was the one who cut the grass most of the time, especially in that house over there, because my older brother, Ace Morologist, bless his heart, is allergic to just about everything. When he was a kid, he had one of those allergy tests done. And back in the late 70s, early 80s, I don't know how they do them now, but back then, the way they did allergy test was they had a bunch of needles, basically, and they would draw a grid on the person's back and inject little bits of different things to see what you have a reaction to. Very, very, that's speaking to my brother. That was him right there. Let me just silence that. I'll talk to him later. So my brother, Ace Morologist, bless his heart, had this allergy test done when he was like 8 or something like that. And of the 30-something, 20-something things, and they test for like cat allergy, you know, if you're allergic to cat hair, if you're allergic to dog hair, dust, mold, I mean, just about anything a person could be allergic to is what they test for, which is, you know, you got to find out if you're allergic to that stuff because you don't want to have some kind of allergic reaction or whatever. But of the 20 or 30 things that they injected into my brother to see if he was allergic to, the only thing that he was not allergic to was goat hair. Yep, goat hair. And of course, we didn't have any goats. So the dogs that we had, he couldn't take care of them. He was allergic to them. The cats that we had, nope, couldn't do that either. Grass, oh yeah, he's definitely allergic to grass. So for God's sakes, you can't let him cut the grass because he'll have an allergic reaction and possibly stop breathing. So guess who got to cut the grass in every house that we ever lived in? Me. That's right, me. I had to cut, I started at like 9 years old. I learned how to ride a riding lawnmower at 9 years old, cutting the grass in every house. Well, that house and this house, of course, because, you know, it's the only two we lived in together. But, yeah, I was a grass cutting maniac. I hate cutting grass. Absolutely hate cutting grass. It's such a pain in my grass that I don't like it. Don't like it at all. Let's see if we have any more. Ollie, you're so cool. Thank you. See if we have any more clay in here. We do. White stained clay. Thank you. That house over there, it wasn't terrible because it was flat. The grass, the property that we had was relatively flat, no hills. This house is not flat. This is it's a vague representation, but it was a very steep hill. This was a very steep hill. So steep that we couldn't do a riding mower. I could not use a riding mower on this hill because if I tried to turn around, I'd flip over and roll down the hill and break a leg or something. And you know, possibly cut off a foot. And, you know, and nobody wants that. Nobody wants to cut off a foot with a lawnmower. So when we moved out of that house into this house, we had to sell the riding mower and get just a regular push mower. The first year that I was in this house, I told my mom, because she got just a regular push mower. It wasn't even a like a self-propelled mower. I was like, no more. I will not cut the grass again. Hiya! Without a self-propelled mower, because it was killing me to try to go up and down this hill, or even just because not only was it steep going like from the road up to the house, it was steep going from like the driveway to that side. So it was just a very steep incline going that way. Awful. So there was a hill this way and a hill this way. I did not like it. I did not like it one bit. So we had to, and of course, hello. I was working at the time, so it wasn't like I was like, I refuse. Like I helped pay for the self-propelled push mower because, you know, I made the ultimatum of I'm not doing it without one. So I helped pay for it. You know, don't think that, you know, I'm some kind of jerk that's going to do that to my mom. You know, she's nice enough to let me live there without having to pay rent right away. So, like, the least I can do is cut the grass and help pay for that. Excuse me, that is not for you. And help pay for the thing that I'm asking for. So I helped pay for the riding or the self-propelled push mower. After I moved out, you know what she did? This is hilarious. You know what she did? She hired somebody to come cut the grass. It's like, well, I'm not going to cut that grass. And I didn't live there anymore. Like me personally, I didn't live there anymore. I did come over and cut the grass after I moved out a few times. But yeah, she ended up just paying for a lawn service to come cut the grass because she wasn't going to do it either. I was like, uh-huh, see? See, she said she tried it one time. I was like, never again. I was like, see? Ow. Oh, God, there's two of them. I was like, see? It's a pain. Where you at? And suck it right between your eyes. And you. One for your friend. One for you. And I'll just take you out with my sword. So, yeah, she ended up getting a lawn service to come cut the grass after I moved out. It's like, well, why couldn't you have just done that when I lived there? Okay, so you would leave out of the garage. This is a storage room here. Let me get this XP. And then you would walk into a little vestibule area here, I guess. And we would hang our keys. There was a wall here. I'll go ahead and throw this in there. There's a wall here. And a wall here. I'm going to have to go get some more clay. I know that I am. That's all right, though. I'll do that, obviously. Hello! I heard you coming, sucker! I'll do that off camera. I'm not going to make y'all watch that. Ha ha! Suck it! Surprise, mother trucker! But yeah, this was a little vestibule area here. Oh, I need to... I changed some of this as I was putting stuff down, so let's... that's not what I need. I need this. This is what I need. Hello, you got an axe. Use it. Proper tool for the proper equipment for the job done. Needed done. And wall here. So this is a little vestibule area. This was the pantry. This is where we kept the food and the dog food and the trash cans. And, you know, it was a little pantry here. It was a little bit bigger than that, but in order to get the storage area and the bathroom correct proportions, I had to make this much smaller than it actually was. You could actually walk in here and get the stuff out of it. But yeah, there's a pantry there. There's a bathroom in here with a window outside. So we'll go ahead and put that window in. There's not a window on this wall, just right there. So you could, and the, it was, see, the toilet, I think, was here. So, yeah. And then, of course, mirror. Let's see. And then this was the kitchen area. So let's go ahead and put the walls up a little bit higher. I don't know that I'm going to have enough to even do the walls that I need to finish in here. Yeah, three high. And it was this was a cramped space, especially what you couldn't open the pantry door and the bathroom door, because the bathroom door, they both opened out for some reason. So you couldn't open the bathroom door if the pantry door was open, because it would clang, clang. You have to close that door, close this door, and then open this door. And vice versa, if this door was open, you couldn't open the pantry door all the way. It was ridiculous. Not a good design there on that, but you know, it worked, whatever. So you would come out of the garage through the little foyer into the kitchen area. Now, we had breakfast table and stuff set up over here, which we'll get to when we do the interior decorating. This was kitchen. There was an island right here, which I'll put in eventually. And then you had stove, oven, refrigerator. Then this was a wall. That was a wall. And here is the steps. The steps that actually they went down to the basement. And then on this side, they went up to the second floor. And then here was the living room. We had the TV on this wall that were put up eventually. We'll go ahead and I got enough to do some of it at least. So we'll put this wall up. And one. Dang. So you had a couch here and TV over there. Had a little chair here for the TV. This is also where we had the, wait, was it there? After a certain incident, which we'll talk about in a couple episodes, she remodeled, and I think she actually ended up putting the TV over there. Or was it over there originally, then over here? I don't know. I have to talk to Razorbutt. She helped my mom with that. So I'll have to talk to her and see which one it is when we first moved in. Because I'm gonna set this up pretty much as I remember it as I was living there. And I'm pretty sure the TV was over here, on a TV stand, and we had a little sofa and a chair. Pretty sure that's how that worked. But like I said, I'll talk to my sister about that. I'm sure she'll be more than happy to help me out on that. Now over here was, you walk in the front door, and again, there was a, because of the hill started right at the front of the house, right around here somewhere, there was a porch that came out and came all the way to the edge of the house, all the way to here. And I'll put that in. We could go ahead and put that in now. Yeah, that's fine. But you would walk in the front door, and over here was when the house was built. The way it was set up was over here was supposed to be like a formal living room. I don't know. And then over here was supposed to be the formal dining room. That's what my mom called them. That's what she wanted when she was looking for houses to get out of that house over there. She's like, I want a formal living room and I want a formal dining room. What those are, I don't know. Whatever. We always ate over there in the kitchen, you know, at the kitchen table. Whatever. But this actually ended up turning into an office. This was like when my mom started working from home. She set up her office here. And this was the formal living room. This is where we had the big dining room. Oh, I'm sorry, the formal dining room. This is where we had the big dining room table. So when everybody, you know, when all the kids came home for Thanksgiving and stuff like that, we'd have dinner here. It had a big table to fit all of us, which ended up turning into a lot of people once, you know, kids started moving out and getting married. And, you know, we'd end up having like 10 or 12 people trying to eat in the formal dining room. Which, again, was actually, this is just a Minecraft representation. It was actually bigger than this. But, you know, like I said, I don't want to make the house huge. So, this is going to be it. This is about the size of it. And then there was a wall here. This wall here for the steps. So, there was a little walkway to go through to get into the living room. There was a walkway here to get into the kitchen area. And, like I said, there was an island here. Like so, And then the sink was here. Dishwasher was there. And then you had breakfast area. Cool. Let's see how long. I've been recording for a good long bit. Let's go ahead and throw this porch in here real quick. Super shovel, super shovel. So it came out. We'll make it too wide because there was a railing on it, and I'm going to need at least a space for the fence that I'm going to put up. Nope. I might need to make it 3 wide. I don't know. Should I do 3 wide? Because it wasn't really that wide. I think we'll just do it 2 wide. So, yeah, like that. And then it would come out here. There was a window here. No. It was here. And this was actually, there was one here as well coming off of, nope, that's above. That's not going to do any good. There's a window here. This is actually like a bay window, which meant that it stuck out a little bit. Or the wall went in a little bit. I don't know. But I don't know how to make a bay window in Minecraft without making it just absolutely humongous. So we're just going to leave it like that. I might make it this big. I don't know. I have to use my nugget on that one. Figure out how I want to do that. But there's a window here to look inside. There was little windows on the side of the door, which I can't do without making the door look funny. Because it was just little narrow, just little skinny windows. So you can, you know, if you're inside, somebody knocks on the door, you can stand next to it and see who it is without standing in front of the door. If you live in a nasty part of town, you know, advice from the fireman. If you live in a nasty part of town, have a way to open the door from the side so you're not standing right in front of it in case somebody wants to kick it in on your face. But, yeah, this seems about right because the porch would come out. You could kind of lean out and see down the side of the house. And then, of course, like I said, there was a hill that came down and it went back up the side, and the back of the house was level with the back. The backyard was level with the house over here. So I might clear out some of this to kind of simulate that a little bit. But there was a window here. There was a window here. There was a window at the bottom of the steps. So you would come down the steps. We always made the joke that if you fell down the steps and hit it the wrong way, you go head first out the window and fall 2 stories. We always thought that was funny because, you know, how is that not funny? There's a window. There's a big window here so you can look out the backyard. And then a little window. And I think there's another big window here to let light into the kitchen. So, yeah, that is the first floor. Well, most of the first floor. I'm going to go to the mesa and get some more of the white stained clay. But, yeah, that's pretty much how the first floor was laid out on our first new home. Drive in. Park, walk in, drop off your keys, and then, of course, as a, you know, young man would, you go straight to the refrigerator, get some food out of the fridge, and go and sit down on the couch, watch some TV, and then go upstairs and do your homework. That's how it should be. Kids, always do your homework. I like it. I like it a lot. And then next episode, I guess I'm going to have to go to the mesa and get a lot of stained clay because we're going to need it for the second floor and for the basement. So I got some work ahead of me at the mesa, but that's not going to be today. That's going to be next episode because that is the end of this episode. So as always, I appreciate y'all for watching. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section below. Ollie, thank you very much for the donation. I'll go ahead and take this now. I don't know. Might use some of that for the ceiling in there. That might be pretty cool. But yes, thank you so very much for watching. Next episode, we'll work on the second floor and possibly part of the roof because the roof is going to be interesting because it wasn't just a regular roof like that. It actually had peaks and stuff. Not looking forward to that. Also, next episode, I'll probably have some more work done on this. Back here is where I was talking about. This actually extended back a little bit. So I'm going to have to do a little filling in back here and extend this out. But that's it. That's going to be the end of this episode. So always, I appreciate y'all for watching. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section below. If you enjoyed it, leave a like. And I will see y'all next time. Bye-bye.